All right, ladies and gentlemen, I thought about I would do this stuff here for you. It was quite a trip. I was pretty damn sure I'm gonna make it to all the way to Zagreb on a money exchange. Exchange Polish currency into euros. It was a frequent, it was a regular stuff that MKUltra members would do. Most frequent was this Merry money exchange, if I can recommend. Upon their assignments in Poland, these MKUltra staff members would literally walk from our house in Novomest all the way to Zagreb. Yeah. Or as Donald Trump referred to me as, well, we did it for you, you know. There is another option. We did it for you, but if you're going to do this, Diaper Donnie definitely helped me out by giving me a really, really good piece of advice on how to Yeah, I'm thinking about the John McCain right now, actually. And Diaper Don, who never served in armed forces. The man who was giving me an advice about, to me, he was giving me advice on how I should and what I should. And if I have to, you know, if you have to, then you do this stuff like this. He is a really arrogant, a diaper Donald Trump. Yeah. So, you know, enough said about that stuff. The way I want to tell you about this video is to get the proof, and it's why I'm recording this stuff. The way you were able to see, or you will be able to see, I had a difficult task and close to zero chance to obtain one. This proof was involved in MKUltra. They did talk about chance to get this kind of proof. It was pretty British that were involved in this stuff too. Prince Harry referred to this proof as close to no chance, close to zero chance. And based on my 4 hours sleep, 5 hours sleep was already good, 6 hours is already luxury for the last 5 years. I can tell you that I feel lucky. I would not even be recording the stuff you see right now. But I want you to know how I got this proof. Because it was really, really close to no chance to get this proof. It was close to no chance to get this proof. Really, on a Sunday, October the 9th, I headed for Zagreb City, as I stated, to the Croatian capital, where I would preferably do this money exchange, because you would get for 700 Polish zloty, you would get 150 euros. And the thing was that I just recorded a video about my neighbors, and I did so to strengthen my body, to clear my mind. That was the main purpose, was hiking, even sleeping inside of the forest. Adventure, something that would clear my head, throwing myself in a river, do a swim in a cold river, two, maybe three, whatever, and return back. But I underestimated the situation severely. I did not anticipate that weather, and it's something that a lady from money exchange office reminded me of once I visited this money exchange office. And let me see where this would actually be. She said to me, a Czech crowns, however, she stated to me. She said to me, well, she said, we don't change them no more. And I was like, really, how come that you don't change Czech crowns no more? Well, she said, since July, the two banknotes you have, and this is all audio recorded, the two banknotes you have, we don't exchange them anymore because they passed they're past their dates. It's over with. We don't do it anymore. It's a new banknotes they issued. And it was really strange because I got them out of the ATMs when in Czech Republic in 2020, that's just 2 years ago. So the Czech people and some others also told me, and this should serve also as a reminder of it. They said to me, well, they said, Sebastian, I'm taking you to the money exchange shop. They told me, well, Sebastian, but this is a money exchange right here, this store right here. Mignon is Azure, you see. That's going to play as next. This money shop here. They told me, if you're going to go past, I don't know, July, something like this, even August, they told me, make sure, because when the weather is going to get late, it's going to get cold outside. And I did not thought about that, to be honest with you. I thought that I'm a bear. I thought that I'm resistant to it because of the swimming in the river, and nothing can really come to me. But I was wrong. As I did pass a considerable amount of distance, on my way to Brežice, and that's exactly the trail you see right here, it's 40 kilometers. As I did pass considerable amount of distance, and I already was in a municipality of Brežice, really, really close to Zagreb. Really, really rich. You know, it kicked a resentment in me against Donald Trump. Anger got me. I started to think about, you know, about this guy. To express myself, excuse me, but he really talked a lot of shit. He didn't have any respect for anybody. And it appears that the least respect he had was for me. Just that I'm not such an easy guy to go along with this kind of stuff. I don't really accept just somebody to do with me just as pleased. To put it in the right language, I did travel further than this, you know. I did go on this side of the river. I took a little further. I took a lot further, I think. And boy, I don't regret. I don't regret at all. This was a really, really good, very, very good trip. But a diaper Don told me, he said to me, talking about Donald Trump, never served armed forces. In my opinion, never went through anything. You ask me. He said, if it's not going to be, it's not going to be anything because of you. We opened one chance here in Brežice, you know, but they all did in Zagreb, you know, in Zagreb, they all did in Zagreb. Well, the truth was about the Zagreb, the truth was that every one of them had rooms waiting on them in either Samobor area or in Zagreb. Psychiatrist Tatiana Prokshor, who was also involved in this stuff, this is the lady who told me, if you're going to mention one more time MK Ultra, just before the 2015, I'm going to call an ambulance vehicle on you. As I did mention MK Ultra, the ambulance vehicle popped up in front of the house at the end of 2014, and I was driven to psychiatric hospital. This is not a joke. The girl had a friend in Zagreb, in a high-rise, where, during the hiking, she would stay at. For one thing, I'm just giving you straight an example about witness that did go through this kind of stuff. However, the list of people who did this kind of stuff is very long. Some even in a royal circus, in British royal circles, that I wouldn't mention because I wouldn't want to embarrass them. They're nice people. They treated me well. So I don't have a tendency to go after the people that were nice to me. But I'm telling you, it's a long list. I'm going to say to you that I traveled to Zagreb on foot 100 times on foot, not travel only, but a drugged up carried for the MK Ultra staff members, their belongings. You get this, drugged up. Don't say anything, it's all right. I like to help people, I don't mind. I'm a strong person, I like that. It's just that they were doing some really bad stuff. Not even the MK Ultra staff members, but other people who did them assignment and stuff like this. At times, they wouldn't let me even sleep for a week. And then they would march you like this, literally try to destroy you, health-wise. You know, so advice from Donald Trump sucks. At this shop here that you see, I remember how this upstairs, when he rented this place, there were beds inside. It's these beds that he would give sometimes MK Ultra staff members that would arrive for this money exchange. That is in Brežice, in Slovenia, right? This city, not in Zagreb, but here. He would let them sleep. Later, if nice, this is how Prince Andrew referred to that, MK Ultra staff members, he would pay them so they could stay. They could get rooms. But for me, at this time of the year, and I really underestimated, I went really like a bear on assignment. I disregarded the weather condition. I disregarded everything. There's actually, it says here, Mrzlava Vas, that's called a cold village, if I was translate. That's pretty much the area where I took my rest. That's right, I penetrated very deep toward Brežice, final location. Something according to police director here from Novo Mesto police, he claimed that nobody did. Everybody managed to get through somewhere up to, well, much, much less than this, anyhow. But I suppose that I was very, very persistent, disregarding absolutely everything. And that same night, even that I left very late, I did manage to get, let's see this stuff here. Now, I'm unsure if I'm gonna know. Well, that probably is somewhere here that should be a forest between this regions here somewhere. Somehow I don't see this forest, but I was there on God knows. I did video recorded. I'm gonna have a video that's gonna detail the villages and stuff that I have gone through, you know. The thing is that in the middle of that forest where I threw myself on the ground, and well, they guaranteed me, the police did, police from Novo Mesto, psychiatrist Peter Kopsch did. Oh, this video is going to be really, really interesting. I'm going to release on how they're going to confiscate me, my belongings, strip me of everything like they did to other MKUltra STEP members. And they came up with the idea that the best way to protect yourself during MKUltra, actually during the trips like this, is to just get yourself inside of this thing here. Wild, how the hell would you say that stuff is? This is what, as a matter of fact, if you get in, if you try to get in here, you're gonna cut yourself badly. You are not gonna make it out without being cut badly. It's definitely going to do you trouble if you're going to try to ambush somebody at night, because he's going to hear you. And it was a police officer investigator who was involved in this, who figured out the way how to protect yourself completely from intrusions, unsuspected intrusions during your sleep, by using some kind of blanket he used. I don't even know how he did this. They were demonstrating this stuff during MKUltra. It afterwards, everybody that used that stuff. But it didn't get to me, this kind of stuff. It was the first time I attempted to do something similar to that. Because in an area where I did this, it's exactly the area where people were also involved in MKUltra. People were involved all along. But there is a specific housing that these people were involved in it, that I recalled from MKUltra. And so I did near that housing, this kind of stuff, without penetrating deep into this wild raspberries, if you want to call this. Did I wrote this properly? Raspberries, okay. Wild raspberries. And didn't take time to actually build myself, you know, shelter, right? Overnight shelter, sorry. People do this, all kinds of stuff like this. I saw this on the internet, really cool. If I would go during the daytime, I would too. But boy, at midnight when I got really, really in vicinity of this Brežice city, I figure out, boy, it's not good for you to continue, I said to myself, because, you know, if you're going to continue, you're going to force yourself, this is just really, really bad for your health. So I said to myself, hold on, let's go and let's have a little sleepover here somewhere. And then what we're going to do is we're going to continue. Once you get better, you get maybe even 4 hours of sleep. You recharge yourself, and then you continue back towards Zagreb, and so on. And so, nothing really came out of that Zagreb, because the night dropped below the zero in that forest. Very, very, very soon I understood that I was just cold in my kidneys all over the place. The cancer just, boy, exploded in me. You know, I could feel the cancer just like never before. I never had a sensation like this. And they also told me on that MKUltra, if you're going to have a cancer, you should not be doing this kind of stuff. It was too late. It was too late. Severely, deeply sleep deprived, with cancer just crawling all over my body. However, I moved on at about 5 o'clock in the morning, and the sleep was horrific. Wrapped in a plastic bags in those wild raspberry bushes in the middle of the forest, I cannot find now, but like I said, I'm gonna have another video coming. I decided to not follow Donald Trump's bullying, how, we did something for you.
The
you know,
protection tonight did, was provided but, to me by what we you found see you here. Something. This is the way it was. Super spiny stuff.
This was my bed, basically.
It will easily rip your ultra in to this.
I didn't want to get surprised. I didn't want to get ambushed. You have no idea the stuff they did during MKUltra to people.
Okay, so we keep going. I made it out of there. I don't.
It's a video. It's a separate video I'm going to do.
This was my.
This was my bed.
My
yeah.
little bed tonight. Exactly the way you see it.
So like loaded this. With a 15 kilos.
That's all there was.
Throw myself on the ground, try to get at least 2 hours.
Right, no.
I couldn't get any. Cancer blown all over
see
my
it.
Body.
You can see the timing.
Shit,
see
now going without a sleep.
I did not get to sleep anything at all, but I got here at midnight. But this day.
And with the cancer crawling all over me. I had forward, but changed my original destination, Zagreb, Croatian capital, instead for Brežice. So Zagreb was off the map, unfortunately. I was sure I'm gonna take one at once. It was completely within the reach. I was already in a region of Brežice. I departed from Krško already. Krško was already behind me. I passed I'm not sure. I think it was somewhere here. Oh, something like this. It must have been here somewhere. So that I get to see this. What? Oh, yeah. That's exactly the forest where I was. There you go. Really quickly, I can take you, probably. Let me see that. I assume. But I assume that this was it here, probably was the place that you have seen I got myself from. Those forests. And I wouldn't waste my time with this stuff. Yeah, it's this kind of cahoots that have provided for me a protection, basically. I don't think I'm in the right place anyhow. So, I did settle for less. And I really, really do not regret this decision. I figure out it was a decision that eventually did even save my life. The sleep deprivation was really bad, and if I would continue regardless it over Zagreb. The police told me that much about this diaper Don. That's why I have no reason to like this guy. This is a crazy, crazy, insane, evil bully, basically. Really is evil. This is an evil guy as he gets. Some people, they told me, could not even make it back to Novo Mesto when they did something shit like this on foot. I know, I can recall many did not. It wasn't about auto stopping anymore for the people that did that attempted stuff like this, but it was about already saving your life from complete ruin. People, I understand, I was told, slept inside of the forest, displaced, and was just trying to somehow maintain because of this cold temperatures, try to survive this shit. So you get yourself in a situation like this, you gotta find a way to get yourself out of it. I recall guys that rehearsed trip to Zagreb on several occasions before those finally managed to get to Zagreb. And they did so by carrying just maybe 3 kilos with them, something like this. But as I stated, I had at least 12 kilos with me. I was heavily loaded, maybe even more. I got to throw that on a scale and see really how much I was loaded, how much stuff I had on me. And so knowing, recalling this kind of craziness, what other people have gone through, and I started to believe this shit because of this cold night, I decided I will in fact do is a wimp money exchange in Brežice here at this guy. This guy, to tell you the truth, this guy was quite evil with me. This guy needed money. He's got a farm I completely have forgotten about. And he needed to purchase new stuff. So he did a lot of evil to me. And his evil ended with how he's gonna change for much less. And there was a tremendously a lot of disinformation involving it. All kinds of stuff, maybe without even his knowledge. Maybe he didn't know there was other people that presented themselves as him. It was a whole cluster. He liked me, at least what his state claimed. But, you know, in return, I only got 142 euros for 700 zloty and kicking my ass, basically. Lady would not really collaborate on much information. He was not even present to give me any information. On my questions, I didn't get them answered. All I had was whatever I managed to record on the phone before I got there. And that was pretty much everything. Anyways. Correct. Everything I have stated about him was correct. Everything was correct. This girl, I was wrong about. She was supposedly even interested in me. Sometimes since 2008, I think, he got her in the picture. I said 2013 to her, and she says it was much, much, much earlier. Well, about 2008. There is other stuff. I remember his farm, everything, but it doesn't make sense. It's a nonsense. He got the purpose. He got his purpose for his bosses in Ljubljana, and that's about it, I suppose. So the chances for me to get the proofs like this because of the sleep deprivation were really, really slender. And what really, really saved me really, really was insecurity in a sense of lack of sleep, in a sense of what I already have experienced before, although I had, did not have reasonable grounds for it, I did copy it and saved files, video files, first on SD card, which was located on the Android phone. And somehow I did it twice, which I think is actually the only thing that saved my life. How, I do not know. When I did copy, paste them on a computer, those files would not exist. Despite all the files I have copied and pasted onto hard drive, the two files, the most important, crucial files I video recorded that day would not exist. I know exactly who, how, and when did this, but it's this who, how that did this, a Slovenian police, which attempted to push me against the people of Bosnia. I told you that this police in Slovenia is pro-Chetnik police. These are the people that collaborate with the Serbs, with the Belgrade. And it's Serbia that is running its war in Bosnia and Herzegovina against the Bosnian people. Also, of course, Croat people and Bosnian people. But it appears that Bosnian people are especially within the reach to them. It was strange when I departed, and the whole thing, the way I recall the information, the way they were playing out the cards, the way they tried to trigger my rebellion against the Croats and against the Bosnian people, according to MKUltra scenario, the way they brainwashed, they heavily, heavily instigated against Bosnian people. Against the Croats too, but against the, well, really actually against the Croats and against the Bosnian people. And they had people involved from Croatia. That's interesting. They had people involved from Croatia and from Bosnia that would display their cars with a registration, with a license plates, cars that I would recognize, that would trigger my memory as I walked on the stuff that went on. Like Croats that would come literally from Zagreb to complain about me to the cities such as Brežice, where I went to do money exchange, and Šentjerne, which is completely insane idea. It's really, really insane. Croatia today literally does not exist because of Mr. Gotovina, nor does exist because of Mr. Tudjman, nor does exist because of any Croatian politic. Every Croatian politic, including Mr. Gotovina, who met me during MKUltra, knows that Croatia exists because of me. And so that you would have people coming all the way from Zagreb to complain about me, yeah, sure. But those are the same kind of people that my neighbors would drive me to the top of Gorjanci. And you had a Serbian minority there on a Croatian side. They would drive me for beatings, for abuse, for torture. And it was not only on top of Gorjanci, but also other locations throughout the Croatia. Because they were desperate to turn me against the Croats. Slovenia, at all costs, wanted to play Northern Serbian state on the Balkans. Which idea was to recreate failed Greater Serbian Chetnik state known as Yugoslavia. Look, Serbs know what I stated, not only Croats, Serbs alone stated me. The stuff that went on during this Oluja operation a thunder, known as a thunder, for those that recognize Mr. Gotovina. This guy here, he served in a foreign legion. And there were like three soldiers, Croats. They were chosen within to run this operation. However, this guy would never get a chance, nor would Franjo Tuđman get a chance. There would be nobody that would get any chance if it was not for me. According to Prince Andrew, it was just inches from making decision to flatten Croatia with the Serbian army during the war for Croatian independence. And Serbs alone have a knowledge that there was stuff, weird stuff that was happening on a war field, where their tanks would be simply hit out of distance with extreme precision, blown apart, ran over by the Croats without having absolutely any ability to defend themselves within. Admissions that no help would be granted to the Croatian state if it was not for me. And I relentlessly insisted on assistance to Croats, that I can absolutely assure you that Croatia got its independence, chance for independence. There's no doubt, these are very brave people. I really appreciate as a neighbors. I am not average Janis. I'm not an average Janis. I'm not average Slovenian. Trust me on that. If I would be, there would be no Croatia today. So when the Serbs alone state you something like this, then you know that you're not far from true. So that's all I wanted to say about this video. This was a very, very difficult stuff to do. Chances to obtain this recordings, the proofs about this stuff, really were close to nothing. You're about to see some serious, serious attempts for me. Crazy stuff, actually, how far crazy I have gone to have not double vision. Basically, to just not disseminate some kind of paranoia. And finally, in the end, yeah, it did not get to me, even if you look at timing. I eventually got the proof that the video recording itself was dated to the 1970, July 1st, 1970. Oh boy, I have not even seen what was in July. What that's supposed to mean? Who is this? The big one. Cromwell. July 1st, 1970. Birthday analyzer. I have no idea. July 1st, 1970. Who was this? What was this? I don't know. I did not play with that stuff. I don't know what it is. But definitely I did not do what you're about to see on those video recordings. I know nothing about IT. I don't know nothing about software. I don't know anything about any of it. Not at maybe. I have no idea because I never attempted to do any stuff like this. I could have done this myself. But this was a proven hack from the Slovenian police with just a little, tiny little proof even left in it that I'm more than proud to present you with. So I just want you to know how this stuff went on. There was many people I have identified on my way to and on my way back. And finally, I saved myself from the hell, from this Krško hell, just as I have described right here, at this page here. Well, I did this really in Slovenian language, yeah, that's why I think it's fair for me to say that this rondo here that you see, this is a main rondo to the city, to the city. You see, this is the main rondo to the city, this place here. And if you turn back to Novo Mesto, there is a pass under this superhighway here that you would go. It's really, really strange. And then it would twist like this. And then this is what would connect you to the Novo Mesto, where you would actually head again this way then, on a highway, through the highway. However, I was told, don't be here. I was told, reminded, if you're going to be here, waiting, doing the auto stopping, hitchhiking, it's this house is here. I was told, all this area here, they have a cameras. They will literally not only monitor, but transmit. They do this to the people, I was told, in the area. And to the people in Ljubljana who decide about the jobs and stuff like this, that's what I was taught. Nobody's going to pick you up. And the only thing that happened was, from the Krško direction, there was all of a sudden a bunch of people. This is Krško. This is where you go to Krško. This was a bunch of people. You see, for Ljubljana, and along the way you go through Novo Mesto, bunch of people that would just bombard me with a crazy looks, extremely disapproval of my website and stuff, that would not stop me. And so I recalled the issue from the Krško Pharmaceutical right here in Novo Mesto. The same shit went on. If you will not lobby for us, for Milan Kučan, for Borut Pahor, for Tanja Fajon, for Drnovšek, for Danilo Turk, for the people, you know, known as ex-communists of Yugoslavia. But they were not communists. I don't have so much against the communism as I have against the people that engaged in ethnic cleansing, genocide against the natives in Slovenia for the sake of what I stated earlier. That's where really my problem is. Nobody will stop you. You can be here all day long and nobody will stop you, really. One time, I was at the Krško Pharmaceutical in Novo Mesto. Man, several hours. I was very, very persistent. Yeah, there would be no car that would stop me. That's right on the across the river where I live at. There's a pharmaceutical company. Big-ass pharmaceutical company where my mom, my dad, my sister used to work. And so, when I thought about that stuff, that there is actually a prospect that I will be spending a day like this, at the bus stop like this, just as was the case here in front of this company here where millions of cars go through, this is in Novo Mesto, yeah? I just said to myself, boy, don't wait. And I took a hike across this hill here that you see. Like this. Completely on the other side of this road here. Which is like a regional road. And then the things moved much faster. Then the things developed very, very quickly for me. But the videos below are definitely worth to see. Really good videos. Oh well, okay. Which trip for me started here? It commenced, the trips commenced here for me. I entered through this bridge, and it was right across this bridge, which probably I'm not gonna make it through, that I started the trip in the Brežice, very intensive, with having an argument with a police officer who was involved in MK Ultra. Heavily, and for not a good reason, for all the wrong reasons, nothing good really. And that's how it all started, and so I recommend this warmly. Here inside in this, oh, there is still nothing there, right, okay. There is actually, from what year is this thing here? See, that's where it all started. And because these people were very, very heavily involved in it. That's a police station right there. I just decided it's where I would start. And very, very quickly then I got a company. They are located right next to the graveyard. A joint graveyard is next door to this police station. Yeah, this is actually information you're gonna need. That's a police station I was talking about. And this here, this is a graveyard. I don't know. Yeah, but it's more than 50 meters away. 150, okay. It's 150 meters away. A giant graveyard, where I actually was even told that if I would ever go to this graveyard to even get myself a water, they would kill me. They did have people from Ljubljana, such as Janković, Kučan, and so on, involved in this stuff. That threatened me, always with the police presence. So, enjoy the video below. There are other videos coming about this trip to Brežice, but this is interesting. This is definitely interesting. Police crime. Follow me every inch of the way. Later on, I'm gonna release also the videos how they planted me again, sale of the products for which they knew are not gonna work. New products at the local stores, you know, that kind of stuff. So it should be worth watching. A chance was close to nothing to obtain this proof, but they were fair enough to at least leave me a little trace. And boy, it's a trace. It's a trace, all right.